Hi, I'm David Landwehr, a private practice endodontist from Madison, Wisconsin. As I write more articles and talk to various dental groups around the country, I have come to realize that I find myself emphasizing the same points over and over. At first, I was concerned by this because I thought my style might seem boring to participants or readers. But ultimately, I came to realize that I'm always trying to accomplish the same treatment goal, so I should be highlighting the same critical points. Everything I do in my clinical practice surrounds one concept: the elimination of bacteria and pulp tissue from the root canal system while preserving maximum tooth structure for restoration and function. There is nothing remarkable about this case. It isn't long or sharply curved. There aren't five or six canals. It is a standard maxillary first molar. The patient presented with a history of pain in the area. Tooth number 14 did not respond to cold testing and was sensitive to percussion. The diagnosis was necrotic pulp and symptomatic apical periodontitis. This is my treatment protocol for a typical maxillary molar. Following access into the chamber, a 10K file is used to confirm entry into the distal buccal, mesial buccal, and palatal canals. The dentin triangle is then removed with a 16mm 2008 vortex orifice opener. The 16mm length allows easier access for patients with limited opening, especially in those difficult to reach second molar teeth. With the orifice open, I will alternate 10 files and a rotary glide path instrument until the working length is obtained and I am patent with a 10 file. In this case, 10 files and a pro glider were used to enhance the glide path. I'm a fan of the ProGlider because the small tip allows entry into small canals and the progressive taper creates more shape in the coronal half of the root, minimizing the amount of work necessary during final instrumentation. After the glide path is followed to working length with the ProGlider, a Wave 1 Gold primary file was used as the final shaping instrument. The flexibility and fatigue resistance of the Wave 1 Gold result in an extremely safe technique while the single file approach is very efficient. As with all mechanized instrumentation, whether rotary or reciprocation, a brushing stroke away from the furcation with lateral pressure on the outstroke allows the file to work most efficiently. After the three main canals are treated, the second canal in the mesial buccal root is located and instrumented. I wait to explore for the MB2 canal because I think this canal is easier to find after the final shapes are obtained in the three main canal spaces. At this point, the roadmap inside the chamber that directs the search for the MB2 canal is most accurate. This sequence also allows more time for sodium hypochlorite to be deep in the three main canals because the final shape has already been achieved. However, the main reason I treat the MB2 canal last is due to anatomy. Most, but certainly not all, MB2 canals meet or communicate with the main mesial buccal canal at some level of the root. Because of this, in many cases, and this is one of them, a mechanical advantage is obtained by completing the final shape in the mesial buccal canal before treating the apical portion of the mesial buccal too. By creating the final shape in the mesial buccal canal, I am making it easier to clean the apical 1/3 to 1/2 of the MB2 canal if the canals join. All instrumentation, both hand and rotary, is done with 5.25% sodium hypochlorite in the root canal system. My disinfection goal is to safely and efficiently deliver sodium hypochlorite to within 2 to 3 millimeters of the working length. In the standard 4-canal molar tooth like this one, I will use 4 or 5 5 mL syringes to deliver sodium hypochlorite through a 30-gauge side-vented irrigating needle. Final rinses with sodium hypochlorite and then Q-mix are done to facilitate smear layer removal and deep disinfection of the root canal system. The final irrigation is enhanced with an endoactivator, and after adopting this irrigation protocol a few years ago, I now see more microanatomy at various levels of the root canal system than I ever did before. I believe these instrumentation and irrigation protocols are resulting in a cleaner root canal system. By incorporating all or some of these techniques in your practice, I hope you will enjoy the same benefits.